What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another edition of Talking Whiskey. I am your solo host. My little fuzzy bearded buddy had to work today, so we are gonna do this all by ourselves, just you and me. So hit that intro. Before we get started on this episode of Talking Whiskey, I want to give a big thank you, a big shout out to my friend Patrick Thomas. Patrick Thomas is the executive producer of the Big D and Bubba Show. He also is the main head boss man of Silverfish Media, and he does an awesome podcast called Five Whiskey Patrick. And on his podcast, Five Whiskey Patrick, Patrick has the biggest names in country music come to his studio. He's got big names in country music radio. He also has these great comedians that come in there, and they all sit down and they all drink whiskey and they have just a good time for about an hour. So Five Whiskey Patrick invited Talking Whiskey to Nashville, Tennessee, to the studio where they record the Big D and Bubba Show. This place was legit. It was awesome. Professional equipment, professional people. It was really quite a great experience. And we wanted to make a great impression, make a big splash, because here at Talking Whiskey, anything worth doing is worth overdoing. So we went to Chattanooga Whiskey Experimental Distillery. Our buddy Tim was happy to throw in two bottles of Chattanooga Experimental Single Barrel, number 50 and number 42, and we brought that to Patrick Thomas. We had a great time. Thank you very much, Five Whiskey Patrick, for including little old Talking Whiskey and amongst all those stars. And guys, check it out. Five Whiskey Patrick, wherever you get your podcasts. And, you know, Josh Daniels is on there, but, you know, listen to all of them because it's a great podcast. And Patrick is a professional. It was really, really a pleasure just seeing how professional people do this kind of thing. And hey, guys, you know what? Let's go ahead and jump into this week's episode of Talking Whiskey. And this week's episode of Talking Whiskey is dedicated to our viewer and our friend, Roger Turner. Roger Turner, we here at Talking Whiskey sincerely do appreciate your support, and we hope that your health has improved and that you can drink along with us to your requested and your favorite whiskey. Well, all right, folks, let's get this show on the road. Our little fuzzy bearded buddy dropped off this bottle of Lusty Claw.
Caw-caw!
What was that? Oh, God. All right, before the show, our little fuzzy bearded buddy dropped off a bottle of Lusty Claw. What was that? That's not an eagle. Oh my God, that sounds horrible. That's horrible. Okay, one more time. One more time. All right, before the show, our little fuzzy bearded buddy dropped off this bottle of Lusty Claw. I know it's coming. I still can't do it. I know it's coming. Okay. Before the show started, our little fuzzy bearded buddy dropped off this bottle of Lusty Claw. Okay, let's just go with it. I mean, in the information age, and that's the best you can come up with, it sounds like someone strangling a crow. What was that? That's the best you can come up with. Okay, let's just go with it. Okay, here we go. We're gonna taste some Lusty Claw right now, and my God, this, look at that. That is substantial. That's like, that cork is, that, man, that's awesome. You can kill somebody with this thing. This thing's like a weapon. That is solid metal, just about. Anyway, the bottle is pretty cool. I mean, it's like an egg shaped. You got this this Lusty Claw logo right here in the on the front of it, and some rope And you can see, can you see on the bottom, they got a little bit of a etching of the eagle. That's pretty cool. That is actually kind of cool. I like that. All right. Well, you know, all of this points to it better be good because the bottle is so good. And let's just give it a shot and see what Lusty Claw tastes like. Here we go. All right. Cheers.
$66. $66. $66.
It costs $66. Lusty Claw tastes like someone's baby bird and cow piss into your mouth. Holy crap, that is horrible stuff. Woo! Not gonna make any friends with the Lusty Claw community. Oh. Oh, $66. All right, so Roger Turner, this is for you. This is the Bulleit. It is the Bulleit Bourbon Frontier Whiskey Barrel Strength. Now this one did also cost a little bit of money. I think it ran me about $70 down there at Riverside Spirits in beautiful Benton, Tennessee. Go buy Riverside Spirits, get you all your whiskey needs. And you know what? I've been really looking forward to this because I do like Bulleit. We did an episode Bulleit versus, I think it was Maker's Mark. And you know what? Ever since then, I've liked Bulleit and I'm looking forward to tasting this. So let's get into it. We'll be right back. All right, well, here we go, folks. Roger Turner, this is to you. May your aim be true when you shoot at that educated man. Cheers. Woo! Well, that is strong. That is a strong bourbon right there. That is a spicy. That is a spicy bourbon. Yeah, definitely. Wow, that's intense. That's an intense bourbon. I get a strong Kentucky straight bourbon taste to it, folks. That's gonna taste like the other Bulleit. That's gonna taste like your Maker's Mark, but just on steroids. It is a very strong taste. I like it a lot. You got your vanilla, you got your caramel, maybe a little bit of fruit. I really like it. I really do like it, but this may not be a beginner's bourbon. This is definitely a bourbon for someone who knows what they're doing. That 62.7% alcohol is gonna get you where you need to go pretty quick. The taste is a very strong taste. I like it, so therefore I love it. I love it. I'm gonna say it right now. I do love this stuff. Thank you very much, Roger Turner. So folks, if you like what you see, hit that thumbs up button. If you want to see more, smash that subscribe button. All comments in the comment section are very, very welcome. Follow us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, follow us on Instagram, and don't forget to watch us next week right here on YouTube. So folks, until next week, peace.